TV changeover, so please stay seated until I call time. Any questions?
Jake Garner.
Heads? It's heads? Surf? Stay? All right, good match.
Saying good luck to Gasquet. Respective baselines to do battle. The number 10 seed from France, Richard Gasquet, against the French Open and Wimbledon champion. This should be a highly entertaining affair. Hopefully both players will play to their potential. Nothing like seeing two heavyweights go toe-to-toe when they're both playing one at the same time. Let's take a look at the final spot that is available. It's Simon, Kiefer and Murray who occupy the first three berths. Gasquet and Nadal will be fighting for the right to take on Andy Murray, who was really unbelievable tonight against Djokovic. Such a good attitude from Murray.
And because of the attitude, everything else worked. His movement, his consistency, and he really broke down Djokovic. Quite a performance.
Well, let's tell you a little bit about the 6 foot man from France, just 22 years of age. He's got 5 singles titles to his name, and those have come on a host of different surfaces. The first couple came at Nottingham on the grass courts. He's won on clay in Gestad, Lyon, Mumbai, which is in India, on a hard court. He's done very, very well so far in his short career. 2008 hasn't been the best of years for him, but things are starting to turn around nicely now. He's firmly cemented himself in the top 20. Many believe that he should be a regular fixture in the top 10. Are you one of those, Doug?
Yeah, I think so. But watching him play this year, I've sort of changed because I've been surprised that after breaking into the first 10, that he hasn't been that mentally tough. The fact that he hasn't competed well in a lot of matches this year. You look at some of his losses, a first round loss in Rome to Luis Horna, a third round loss in Monte Carlo to Sam Querrey. Those are losses that typically on a clay court you would figure him in a big way.
He has been a finalist at this very tournament, so some good memories. Did well in the opening round to beat his countryman. Never easy when you play somebody from your own country and then the Russian qualifier in the second round. Nice convincing win. But for me, the impressive win was the straight sets victory over David Ferrer, who we know is one of the best competitors out there. Gives you absolutely nothing and really tested the Gasquet, but Gasquet came up with all the answers.
You have to be playing well to beat David Ferrer 3-3.
Well, he really has lit up 2008, 22 years of age, at 29 singles titles, and at the moment he's on a 14 consecutive winning finals run. So he'll want to keep that going. That dates back all the way into Monte Carlo back in April 2005. Held the number 2 spot for far too long as far as he's concerned, and he's got a chance in the next 2 weeks to rectify that.
I think it's going to change. I think the number 1's going to be showing up there rather quickly. And you talked about the 14 match final winning streak. He's also going for a 27th straight match win this evening. Since the Rome loss, second round to Juan Carlos Ferrero, he won at Hamburg on the red clay, the French Open on the red clay, and on the grass at Queens and Wimbledon. And this is how he's gotten here. Not too difficult to draw for him. Levine tested him up 4-1 in that first set, and Andre have tested him in the second set. But I think like all good players, they get better through each and every round. And now as he gets closer to the semis and the finals, he starts to smell the victory, the tournament victory.
But he is so tough to beat in these events, isn't he? He has got 11 career Master Series Shields in 15 finals. And when one considers how tough these draws are, those are scary numbers. Not even the great Roger Federer posts those impressive numbers in Master Series events. obviously utterly dominant on clay for the last three seasons, but starting to show his mettle as well on the hard courts. A bit of history between these two, and it's Nadal who has come out on top every single time. 4-0 against Gasquet. The last time he needed three sets to beat the Frenchman, that was back in the Tennis Masters Cup in Shanghai, where he won 6-4 in the third. But he's been pretty dominant over the Frenchman the time before. At the French Open, he beat him in straight sets and lost just one set in Monte Carlo. So most of their encounters have been on a clay court, and the one other encounter on a hard court, Nadal came out on top. So if you're a betting man, there's no question who you should be putting your money on tonight.
But I think there's two things that Gasquet can take away from what we just showed. Number one, that match in Shanghai, he played well. He had a good chance. He was up a set, and he was really threatening to win that match in straight sets before Nadal turned it around like he does on so many guys. And the second thing is, even though he's never beaten Nadal 4-0, well, the match prior to this, it was Djokovic who had a 4-0 record against Murray, and Murray won. So you know what? You look for some positives.
This is a big match for Jake Garner. We haven't seen him doing too many center court matches this week, so moment for him too. Yeah, we have an umpire rankings as well in the commentary booth, and Jake is one of those up-and-comers.
Yeah, I think he's playing the qualies over the first 6 months of this year, actually. Mohamed Layani dominating so far. Carlos Menardis closely following.
Uncle Tony has been by his nephew's side from the very beginning. It must be amazing to sit down with him and pick his brain about everything he's been through with his son from the very early
days,
because there are so few coaches, in inverted commas, that have ever been through that experience. And you don't see it too often. Rafa's girlfriend, good to see her in the house. She was here last year. Must be the right time of the year. Perhaps still summertime in Spain. University is probably still out, and she's enjoying the summer with her boy.
Yeah, they were in Montreal together last year. I remember I was watching a little bit of golf, British Open, I believe it was, with Rafa and her last year in Montreal. And they were cheering for Sergio. And let them down a little bit.
Well, it's been a good time for Spanish sport in the last month or so, with Spanish footballers taking the honors in the Euro 2008 competition, the biggest football competition outside the World Cup, obviously with Nadal taking the honors at the French and Wimbledon. And there's a Spanish rider, I believe, that's in contention to win the Tour de France tomorrow. So, amazing month. Well, it's the last of the quarterfinal matches between Richard Gasquet and Rafael Nadal. Andy Murray awaits the winner. He was in fine form against Novak Djokovic in the match prior to this one.
Well, I think Gasquet's got to come out firing. He's got to try to get on top of Nadal as quickly as possible. Otherwise, it could be a short evening for the French.
Thank you. First set. Thanks, and to serve.
Coach of Marcus Baghdatis is now taking on the responsibility of coaching Richard Gasquet. Oh.
40 love.
Yeah, it's always tough when you've never beaten someone to get that first victory. Just ask Andy Murray about it.
Yeah,
that's what he did tonight. Shot with it. That's what he could do the same.
I think like a comfortable service hold at the start of such a vital match, big match. Just settle the nerves.
Now, unlike Nadal, who hasn't played since Wimbledon, Gasquet actually went and played a clay court tournament after Wimbledon.
Yeah, Stuttgart, I think he was just trying to get a few more matches under his belt before coming into these big events in North America. He's probably one of those players who can adapt pretty quickly from the clay to the hard, so he wasn't too concerned about that. Obviously, it looks so far like he's done the right thing because he finds himself in the quarters here. Master Series event. Nothing to be sneezed at.
Disaster to happen. One match at a time. Can't control anything other than that.
I love listening to his interviews because he's getting pretty fluent in English. And
whenever
they ask him a question that's a little edgy or perhaps a little bit confrontational or personal, he pretends he doesn't understand.
No.
Excuse me?
No.
It's just a lovely way of diffusing a potentially tricky situation.
It's a good match, no?
So rare today amongst professional athletes to see such humility. It's so refreshing. That's why he's got so many fans.
Well,
especially when you've got so many athletes beating their chest. I'm the daddy, always pointing to themselves. His racket do the talking. Wow. Just mishits this one. Just get hold of it. You know how quick Nadal is.
That's 3 points.
sure if that was necessary to stop the point. The vibration dampener in Gasquet's racket.
Richard, you know if that happens again, you're going to lose the point, okay? Yep.
Aggressively, I like that. We saw him really have a lot of success last night coming against Ferrer.
In fact, I think at one stage he was like 12 of 12 points won at the net. Didn't lose a single point against someone. Horses extremely well.
That shot, no real pressure on him in the middle of the court, and puts him in a world of trouble only in the third game.
Against Andy Murray. It's almost unplayable for 2.5 sets before finally relenting. Thought of it. Didn't want to waste a challenge.
Clearly. Well, that's close. Just see how Nadal keeps pressing Gasquet behind that baseline, dictating the play, bossing the points around early on.
And Nadal.
That's a poor way to lose a serve. It drops up even halfway up the net. Nadal strikes the first blow.
Nadal leads 2 games to 1.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This year, Emirates Airlines has a Dubai. Thanks, Emirates Airlines.
Pretty much a full house here at the Rexall Tennis Center. Rogers Masters Toronto. The 6th Master Series event of the year. Matches, always a special occasion in North America. Such a buzz around the stadium. So popular over the years.
Yeah, I just think the fact that you have people that work hard during the day, they want to get out, they want to enjoy sport, they want to be able to relax, and the environment just makes for energy, electricity, and drama.
Say that the U.S. Open was the catalyst for this kind of tradition that spread throughout the whole of North America now?
No doubt about it, yeah, because of the coverage that they got not only there with fans in person, but television. Certainly playing at nighttime under the lights, the matches with Sampras and Agassi, the Williams sisters, the world's good.
Nets.
You can forget some of those night matches with Jimmy Connors
and
co.
Yeah, you can go back. Basketball, football, typically during the week, most of those games are held in the evenings. People are home from work so they can get through their work day and then go out and enjoy. And on the weekends, well, you sit home and a lot of people are couch potatoes watching all those sports. So that's why tennis, when it comes at nighttime, it appeals to so many people.
And so well attended.
It's because of guys like Uncle Tony, people that he surrounds himself with. Camp, support, so solid.
Ethics. How often do you see Uncle Tony clapping for their opponents? Classy individuals.
Lead. Nadal really comes under microscope.
It seems to me that he's coming to this match with a specific aggressive. We saw the last point him teeing off on the forehand and doing it. The very next point, 157 k's per hour. And he's decided, obviously, that he's going to take this one to Nadal.
That's how he won their first set when they played the Tennis Masters Cup in Shanghai in November. Same thing. Just couldn't sustain it. That was the problem.
15.
Good memories here. 2006 was the runner-up to Roger Federer.
40-15.
It was a feel-good factor when you return to a place where you previously done well. Serve here in the opener.
Time.
An explosive start, to say the least. Both players having broken early on in this match.
Away from that one,
I
Robbie.
So, yeah, but it's close.
It's tough, but players, when they hit the ball, they pretty much have a feeling if it's good or not. Let's see how his feeling is.
Said it many times, it's such a difficult line to call the baseline, especially if you're a player, so much from the linesman's point of view. But when that ball bounces right underneath your nose, players often get it wrong.
Using all the real estate, moving the doll side to side, and then when he gets the one that he can go for, he doesn't make a mistake with it.
Him in the least. This is the response. Swift and decisive.
I'll show you how to pull the trigger. Anything that Nadal's dropping a little bit short, he's paying big time for right now. Gasquet just swinging away, almost in a zone.
what both players have brought the heavy artillery tonight.
And they're both exchanging huge body blows right now and absorbing them. And then Gasquet hit a pretty good volley, but the problem is Nadal's backhand on the run with the second hand on top of the racket gives him so much control and power, and he moves to that side brilliantly. I think that side's everywhere as good as the forehand side.
This one's not going to have the desired result for the escape. We're pretty much sitting right over there.
Three gets off.
No, Rob, as well as he's playing, he's even. Three all. Got to keep it up.
Tough thing. What do when you play against a player like Nadal to stay with them early on? That's exactly what Gasquet has been able to do so far.
Can do with that forehand, except probably get back behind the baseline and defend, and that's why the drop shot's so effective. Another amazing, intelligent play from Nadal. Not only lobbing well, but over the backhand side. The most difficult shot, I think, to play in tennis, the backhand overhead.
That's for sure.
As well as Gasquet's playing, Nadal close to going up a break, so Gasquet's got to stay positive.
His game, playing high risk tennis but with high reward, but sooner or later that catches up with you. Is the best way to describe him. Back in front again with the break.
Time.
You got to stay up now, Robbie, if you're Gasquet, because you've played so well and still find yourself down a break.
Well, that's the difficult part. New balls.
A little lesson last time he broke serve. He gave it right back the very next game, couldn't consolidate. Don't think that's going to happen this time. 9 consecutive points for Nadal.
Unusual to see, because normally Nadal is such a good front runner. And when he gets his nose in front, he's able to just build momentum so quickly and run away with the match. And that's exactly what's happened here in the second half of this opening set. He's got the second break of serve and has consolidated quickly.
Thank you.